The first step to setting up your Amazon seller account is to go to sell.amazon.com and you're going to click on the sign up button. But warning, be careful, because there's actually two different ways that you can sell on Amazon. You can sell with the professional plan, that's going to cost you $39.99 a month, or you can sign up with the individual seller account, which is free to sign up for. To get there, you'll have to scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page and click on this button that says sign up to become an individual seller. They kind of hide this feature, and it's a good hack to save a lot of money, especially if you're just starting out selling on Amazon. The truth is, you can always upgrade your account from the individual seller to the professional account later on. But the problem with the individual seller account is you have to pay an extra 99 cents for every product that you sell on Amazon. So if you plan on selling 40 or more items, I recommend going with the professional plan up here. Plus, the professional plan comes with a lot of other features that we're going to talk about later in this video. I actually chose the professional selling account for our brand new product, Carnivore Jerky. I'm documenting the entire thing right here on this YouTube channel, and right now I'm going to prove how easy it is to sign up for an Amazon account using this brand, Carnivore Jerky, as a case study. I recommend most of my students to sign up for the professional plan when they are creating their Amazon seller account. The good thing is, Amazon is only going to charge you for the first month that you sign up, and they're not going to charge you again until you actually start selling your products on Amazon. You want to make sure that you sign up for your Amazon seller account a few months before you actually plan to start selling on Amazon, because sometimes there's delays in getting your account approved. You want to make sure that when you're ready to start selling, your account is fully approved. Now, a huge warning. There's 5 mistakes that people commonly make when signing up for their Amazon seller account that ends up leading to them getting banned from being able to sell on Amazon. It makes it so their Amazon seller application gets denied. I'll be sharing all 5 of these common mistakes here in this video. The first mistake that people make is when they click on the sign up button as they create a new Amazon account, even though they had an old Amazon seller account. Amazon will see this and will say, wait a minute, are you trying to create a second seller account? And this is not always allowed, although Amazon has loosened up a lot on this since we first started selling over 5 years ago. There are situations where it is okay to have more than one seller account, but I always recommend that if you already have a seller account, to contact Amazon from that seller account and ask for permission to start a new seller account. If you already have a professional account or a personal account with Amazon, you can log in. Or if you're creating a new account because you want to keep your personal and your business account separate, you can click on the Create Your Amazon Account button. You're then going to put in your name. And for anyone that's new to this channel, my name is Connor and I'm head of operations here. And I work alongside Travis helping launch products on Amazon. You're also going to put in your business email. And this is the second mistake that people make. I recommend that when signing up for your Amazon account to use a real business email at your domain name. I would personally avoid using a Yahoo or a Gmail. For Carnivore Jerky, we used a business email to sign up and our account eventually did get approved. But if you have a real business email set up, I would go ahead and use that. After that, you're going to put in a secure password and you're going to click Next. Now you're ready to start your application for your Amazon seller account. Amazon will tell you everything that you're going to need to have ready and you're going to scroll down and you're going to click Begin. Before I show you the next step, make sure to like this video because this is part of a series of videos I'm doing on YouTube showing you every single step of starting an Amazon business in 2025. And we're using this product, Carnivore Jerky, as an example for the entire series. The next question that Amazon is going to ask you is, where is your business's location? You can sell on Amazon US no matter what country you live in. In this case, we are located in the United States. Amazon will then ask you, what is your entity type for your business? There are a few different options here. The most common answer to this question is either privately owned business or none, I'm an individual seller. So if you have an LLC, a DBA, or an S Corp, you're going to click privately owned business. On the other hand, if you're just an individual seller using your social security number, you're going to click on none, I'm an individual seller. And if you are located outside of the United States and you're looking to sell inside the United States, I would recommend opening up an LLC using a website like doula.com or LegalZoom, both of which I'll have links in the description for you. Before we go to the next step, I do want to explain the difference between a DBA, an LLC, and an S Corp, and explain to you which one you should choose. If you're looking for the most affordable option, I would recommend going with a DBA, which stands for a Doing Business As. This is going to cost you around $99 and you can file with LegalZoom or other websites that I'll list below. This will allow you to open a business bank account and a business credit card using a business name. It will also allow you to get an EIN, which stands for Employer Identification Number. This is basically like a social security number for your business, and you'll need this number when opening up a bank account, a seller account, a credit card, or any new financial institution for your business. On the other hand, LLC stands for Limited Liability Company, and this offers you a lot more protection. It makes it so that if someone sues your business, they can't come after your own personal assets. It basically separates you from your business. With a DBA, on the other hand, if someone sues your business, they can come after you and your personal assets. There's no legal protection between you and your business. But the problem with an LLC is it's going to be a little bit more expensive. It's going to cost you at least $150 just to register for an LLC, plus another $150 in fees in the state that you file in. But this does depend on what state you live in. For instance, in California, it's going to cost you at least $250 just to file. Plus, every year you'll have to spend even more than that on fees on top of that, even if your business doesn't make any money. The last business entity type that you may want to consider is an S-Corp. An S-Corp is actually just a structure of LLC and comes with many tax advantages. An S-Corp is actually just a business structure, and you can even set up an LLC with an S-Corp structure, which actually can help out a lot when it comes to how you file your taxes at the end of the year, although I am not a CPA and I recommend consulting a CPA for any tax-related decisions that you may make. We didn't create an LLC for Carnivore Jerky, but this is because we already had an LLC for our Carnivore brand, which includes our other products like Carnivore Electrolytes. But the reason we have an LLC to begin with is because this is a product that a lot of people are going to consume, and there's a chance that someone might sue the business. If you're operating a business where there's a very low likelihood someone is going to want to sue you, you can always do a DBA to save a little bit of money. For this example, we're going to click on privately owned business, and then you're going to put in a business name as it appears on the documents and click I confirm that my business location and type are correct. We're going to scroll down and click on agree and continue. You'll then put in your company registration number, and you're going to get this once you apply for your LLC or your DBA. You can also fill out your registered business address, and this is wherever your business is registered. And you're going to put in a phone number that they can use to call and verify that you are a real person. After that, you're going to put some information about you or whoever the primary contact person is for this business. Generally speaking, it's going to be you. And then you'll put the country of citizenship and your country of birth, as well as your date of birth. You're going to scroll down and they're going to ask you how you want to prove your identity. And if you have a passport, I recommend going with a passport. If you do not, you can always use a driver's license, depending on the country. You'll then select the country where your document was issued, and they're going to ask for your passport number and the date of expiration. They'll also ask for your residential address, and you'll have to fill out all the information right here. And if you're the one that owns the business, you're going to click on Confirm if primary contact person is the beneficial owner of the business. If you're opening a business for a different person, you'll select the other options down below. If you've added all the business owners, you'll go ahead and click Yes. If you've not added all the business owners, click No, and Amazon will ask for some more information about the business owners. So then check on this box and click the Next button. For the next section, you're going to need a valid bank account number as well as a valid credit card. And this is the third most common mistake that get most people denied from being able to sell on Amazon, and sometimes even banned. If you try to use a debit card, or specifically a prepaid debit or credit card, oftentimes Amazon will not accept that and they will ban you. And they're not going to really tell you why. So make sure that you have a valid credit card. We'll then click Continue. You're then going to click Add a bank account, and it's going to ask you whose name is on the bank account. Is it your personal name? Is it your business name? If you do have a business bank account and the business name is the same name as your LLC, you'll click on that button. But if your bank account is in your personal name, then you'll click on your personal name. We did an in-depth video showing how we got the LLC for Carnivore Jerky, the EIN, and the business bank account. I'll link the video up here, and I'll also link the entire playlist of this series where I'm starting this Amazon business from scratch in the description down below. Then you're going to select which bank is your financial institution associated with. For Carnivore Jerky, we ended up going with US Bank because they have free business banking. And not all banks have free business banking accounts. If you're not in the US or you're traveling, you can always open up a bank account with Payoneer or First World Bank. You're then going to put in the routing number as well as your bank account number. And if you have any checks, the routing number is going to be that first 9-digit number, and the bank account number will be the second number on the check. You'll then scroll down and click on Verify Bank Account. You're then going to put in your credit card information for your monthly subscription fee. As a reminder, they're only going to charge you this once, and they're not going to charge you again until you start actively selling on Amazon. So you'll scroll down and then you'll put in your credit card number, the expiration date, and the cardholder's name. You're then going to scroll down and click Next. At this point, you're going to put your store's name. And your store's name can be whatever you want it to be. I recommend having it be the same as your LLC, but it doesn't need to be. If you want it to instead be the name of your product, that's okay as well. In this case, our store name is going to be Peak Primal, and this is the name that people are going to see on Amazon when they buy our product or they come to our store. Amazon's then going to ask you, do you have a universal product code? A UPC code is the barcode that's on just about every single product in the world. When you go to Walmart or when you go to a store and they scan that barcode, that is the UPC code. So if you're selling products that you've bought from a retail store, they're already going to have a UPC code. But if you're selling your own passion product, a brand new product like a private label product or a passion product, which is what I recommend selling on Amazon, then you will need your own UPC code. And you can go to gs1.org and click on Get Your Barcodes to buy barcodes. You can buy a single barcode for as cheap as $30. For Carnivore Jerky, we did buy UPC barcodes through GS1, so I'm going to select Yes. It's then going to ask you if you have any diversity certifications for your business. If you are a minority, women, veteran, or LGBT-owned business, I recommend applying for one of these diversity certifications. Amazon does sometimes highlight companies with these certifications in the search results as well. However, in this case, we do not have any of these certifications, so I'm going to select No. The last question is, are you the manufacturer or brand owner for any of these products you want to sell on Amazon? We are the brand owner, even though we are not the specific ones manufacturing it. We own the brand, so in Amazon's eyes, we're going to select yes for this answer. We did do a video as part of this series where we went in depth and talked about how we found a manufacturer, and I'll link that down below and up here as well. Another question they'll ask is, do you own a government registered trademark for the branded products that we're going to sell on Amazon? And we do. We did apply and received a trademark for this product. So I'm going to select yes, and I'm going to talk about how we applied for this trademark in a later video on this series. So make sure that you subscribe to get that video. Then we're going to click on the next button, and it's going to take us to the final screen where we're going to verify all of our information. As we scroll down, it's going to ask us to upload a passport. You can take a high quality photo or do a scan of your passport and upload it here. It's going to ask for our proof of address, and there's a few different ways that you can do this. You can upload a bank account statement or a credit card statement. You can print that off as a PDF and upload that document here as well. You're then going to select Next. And this leads us to the fourth mistake that people make when applying for the Amazon seller account, and that's not being patient. Sometimes it does take a little bit of time for Amazon to approve your account. But before I go to the fifth most common mistake that ends up getting people banned from selling on Amazon, let me quickly show you some of the pros and cons of the individual versus the professional selling plan. As I mentioned before, with the professional selling plan, there is a $39.99 monthly fee. However, as I said, there's a 99-cent fee per item that you sell if you're on the individual plan. That's why, again, if you plan to sell 40 or more items, just go with the professional plan. Because on top of that, the professional plan comes with all of these other features that we're going to go over. For instance, if you have the professional plan, you can manage inventory using spreadsheets and reports, which makes it so that if you're uploading a lot of items, it's going to make it a lot easier. There's also some other advantages to being able to manage inventory using spreadsheets. For instance, you can have a lot more control when you're uploading your item using a spreadsheet, and it makes it easier to change certain things. You're going to be able to manage orders using order reports and order-related feeds if you have a professional plan. And if you have the professional plan, you can set up your own shipping rates for your products. And this is really helpful if when someone buys a product on Amazon, you're going to be the one shipping it. Now, this is called FBM, which stands for Fulfilled by Merchant, and it's one of two different ways that you can sell on the Amazon platform. The other way that you can sell on the Amazon platform is called FBA, which stands for Fulfilled by Amazon. FBA allows you to send all of the products that you want to into the Amazon warehouse, and whenever you get a sale on Amazon, Amazon's going to pick, pack, and do all the shipping for you. If you enroll in the FBA program, it's also going to make it so all the products that you send into the warehouse are Prime eligible, meaning that when people are scrolling on Amazon and they see your product, they're going to know that if they buy it, they can receive it in just 2 days. And people are much more likely to buy Prime eligible products. So I genuinely recommend using the FBA program. But if you are going to be using the FBM program, there's another reason why you might want a professional seller account so that you can change the shipping rates. You can also get access to promotions and gift services. This will allow you to sell your products at a discount and do special offers that are going to lead to getting more sales. There's a bunch of other things that you'll get with the professional selling account that you just don't get with the individual seller account. But the fifth most common reason why people get banned from selling on Amazon is as soon as they get approved, they go in and they change the credit card details. They change the bank account details. And this is a red flag to Amazon because Amazon's assuming that you're trying to trick the system. So do not change your credit card details or bank account details for at least a couple of months after your account has been approved. And if you're looking to sell on Amazon, I have an entire series where I use carnivore jerky as a case study, and you can watch all those videos right here. And we talk A to Z through every single step of starting an Amazon business. I have a dedicated video to every step of it, so click on that playlist. I'll see you in the next video, and thanks for watching.